Only Up is a game that everybody has been talking about lately, where the goal is to climb all the way to the top of the world to beat the game. With the speedrunning community for this game having over 1,500 runners, the competition is very fierce. However, my goal isn't to become the best of the best, but to defeat the popular YouTuber Ludwig in the Any% Launchless speedrun. Why Ludwig, do you ask? Well, if I beat Ludwig, I can shamelessly farm his name in my YouTube video and thumbnail for clout. Look, a small YouTuber with 8k subs has to make it big somehow. Now let me outline all of the goals that I have for this game. First, I need to beat the game casually, which I will do without any help or spoilers, and I will time myself while doing so. According to howlongtobeat.com, the average completion time for this game is 5 hours and 59 minutes, so I'll be happy if I beat that. Next, I need to watch Ludwig's PB, which is a 33:21 as of the time of this recording. To keep this fair and entertaining, my goal is to beat Ludwig's PB while using his strats and small optimizations that I figure out on my own. That means I am not allowed to watch the world record or do any big skips that Ludwig doesn't go for. If I beat Ludwig's time, I'll learn some new strats from the world record and try to improve my PB even further. Well, that's all of the goals. Before I show you how this went, I'd like to thank the sponsor of this video, Raid Shadow Legends, for putting food on my table and keeping me alive. Raid Shadow Legends is the hottest turn-based RPG available on PC and mobile devices, featuring thrilling PvE content, a lot of champions to collect, and very tactical PvP content as well. With over 700 unique champions, each with their own unique skills and abilities, you are bound to find the perfect one for you. With 12 unique dungeons, each featuring fierce bosses, there's plenty of loot you can earn by taking on these challenges. You can also battle players from all over the world in three different PvP modes, including the new Live Arena mode, which has you take on an opponent in real time. Raid is constantly getting new updates as well, so there's always something fun and challenging to look forward to. With Play and Play, you can play Raid from anywhere and transfer your progress between PC and mobile devices. Your champions in Raid are extremely customizable, with millions of different artifact combinations, team compositions, and strategies to test out. I've been rocking Athel with the full lifesteal set, and man is she good. For new players, you can obtain Stagnite, one of the best champions in the game, and you can obtain a cool skin for him that's designed by JonTron by using the code JTSKIN by October 7th. For current players, you can still get Stagnite through an in-game event. And recently, they've added Hydra Clash, a new clan-based competition where you and four other clans can see who can smack the Hydra boss the hardest. With all of this new exciting stuff coming to Raid, there's no time to wait. And once you're in the game and crushing your opponents, you can join our clan, the Shade Brigade, and we can level up together. So just click the link in the description or scan the QR code to get started, which gets you a free starter pack to jumpstart your Raid journey. And now, back to our regular scheduled programming. Before I speedrun any game, I first make sure that I've beaten the game casually and experienced the game how it was intended to be. And let me tell you, this game was a struggle for me at first. First off, because I have some bad RSI in my hands, RSI standing for repetitive stress injury, I had to play this game with a controller. Thanks to the Steam Deck, pretty much every game on Steam can be played with a controller, though this game specifically doesn't have any native controller support. Basically, you can map keyboard buttons and mouse inputs to the controller buttons and analog sticks, so it was a bit funky. But I got used to it eventually. I'll spare you the details of the playthrough, but let's just say that I fell a lot. And I mean a lot.
Whoa. We're in Elsa's ice palace.
What?
What? No way. Oh no. Guys. What is the rainbow bridge called?
What? What? What the hell is this? Hello? What?
Is it literally all the way back down to the bottom? Yeah, I was dead inside. However, I ended up beating the game in 5 hours, 52 minutes, and 30 seconds, which is about 7 minutes faster than average. I knew I had a lot of work to do though if I wanted to beat Ludwig, so the next day I watched his run.
I learned a lot of cool things from Ludwig's PB. First off, Ludwig played a lot better than I expected. He had pretty clean movement in the early game and I was very impressed. He did a lot of things in this run that I had no idea you could do, which I will go over soon. The big outlier in his run was this dragon skip that he goes for. If you go fast enough, you can use this jump pad to get on top of the dragon, after which the dragon takes you all the way to these flags, which skips a lot of platforming.
In Ludwig's PB, however, he fails the dragon skip, tries to climb up to the top normally and falls, and then waits for the dragon for quite a while, which he then is able to jump on successfully. This was a massive time loss and the biggest opportunity I have to beat Ludwig, but I still need to play the rest of the game really well. After I watched all of Ludwig's run, I tried to do a run of my own, but I soon realized that this strategy was not going to work. Instead, I downloaded the Only Up Trainer mod made by user Tom, which allows you to save your position and teleport back to that position whenever you want to. With this incredibly helpful tool, I started practicing the game in chunks until I was able to repeat each section 3 times in a row. First, I practiced this bed jump at the train station. What Ludwig does is jump from this tree, then to the bed, and from the bed goes to the roof here. Since I'm playing on the latest patch, there's no tree here. I was having trouble jumping from the bed to the roof since it would yeet me in the completely wrong direction, but I figured out a different strat where I can mantle on the side of the bed and then bounce on the bed to the roof. And you can mantle onto that like and subscribe button to get this video out to more people. We're getting so close to 10k subscribers and you have the chance to be one of my first 10k subs. The next big skip was the windmill skip, which I had a very difficult time with. Thankfully, I had some cool people in my chat to help me understand the timing and positioning of the jump, and about an hour and a half later, I was able to get the jump somewhat consistently, and even figured out how to jump from the windmill straight to the roof of the bus station where the bed is. This is a pretty big potential time save over Ludwig since he climbs up to the bus station on the right side and loses some time. I decided to end my practice session right here for the day. I spent day 3 practicing the rest of the game. The big trick I had to learn was the bed bounce up to the halfway point, which was really tricky at first. I then realized as long as I was standing on the edge of the gold bar here, I made the bed jump every single time. I was finally done with learning half of the game. The rest of the tricks would be pretty simple for the most part. The bed jump from the chess area to the globe looks really scary, but once I learned that you can land in front of the sunflower, it was much easier than I had expected. The jump from the cannon up to the ice area was something I did in my casual playthrough, so that was easy. And the champagne bottle jump to the island was free. All that was left was to learn the dragon skip, and this took me forever. I spent over 3 hours practicing the movement to the dragon, and this was the only skip I couldn't do consistently 3 times in a row. At this point though, I said enough is enough, and I decided to do some runs. I'd still go for the dragon skip in runs, but if I failed it, I could still save time over Ludwig by climbing up normally and not falling down on my way up to the space section. At the end of this day, I decided that I would complete my very first speedrun of this game, but something terrible started to happen. My game kept crashing, not once, not twice, but 3 attempts in a row. Something was clearly wrong with my game, and I didn't know what. And that's when I told my stream that if these crashes kept happening tomorrow, I'll have to quit this project entirely. All hope was lost, but after I ended the stream, my only up grind was saved. I went to Google and looked up how to fix these fatal error crashes, and I stumbled across this thread from the Steam community page where someone fixed their game by forcing it to use DirectX 11 instead of 12. I tried doing that, and it worked. I was extremely excited to finish a run the following day, and not only would I finish a run and get my first PB, but I would do this 4 times in one day. Day 4 was wild, and one of the most fun days I've had in a while. My first run was a 1:10:15. Obviously, this isn't amazing, but we all have to start somewhere. This was a pretty rough run with time loss pretty much everywhere. I just wanted to finish a run so that I could submit it to the leaderboard and have something decent to run against instead of a 5.5 hour playthrough. Funny enough, I actually got dragon skip here on the first try, but fell down to the bottom of the dragon section and lost a lot of time. I was determined to keep improving. The next run was a bit better, a 54:58. I had better execution overall, but fell several times in the first half of the run. I was struggling to bounce off of the bed up to the highway, but with some help from chat, I figured out a consistent spot to jump from. This time I failed dragon skip and fell a lot in this section and in the space section.
Oh, I almost missed the last jump, dude. That would have been horrible. No way.
Oh, what am I doing?
Next run, I improved by 5 minutes and got a 49:40. This run, I failed the windmill skip and lost a lot of time at the boss's office sign. I also failed the big bed jump to the globe, but ended up saving it by rolling in the air, which canceled my forward momentum and sent me straight down to this platform. Had I not done this, my run probably wouldn't have PB'd. However, on my way up to the pirate ship, I fell again, But this time, the fall was much worse. I got a bit lucky and landed on this hot air balloon which had a trampoline on it, and I was able to get back to the halfway point from there. I lost so much time, but still believed in my ability to PB. My movement from that point was pretty solid until the dragon section, where my jump input got eaten and I fell down to the cannon, which thankfully didn't lose too much time. Unfortunately, I couldn't go for the dragon skip, since once the dragon spawns, it's impossible to despawn it to reset its position, so I had to climb up normally. I did yet another run after this. This run was looking really good, but then I fell at the highway and the jump to the trampoline. After these mistakes, the rest of the run went very smoothly until the dragon section, and this is where a series of unfortunate events happened. After failing the dragon skip, I tried to climb up normally. As I was trying to jump from the red car to the white car here, I accidentally fell onto the beanstalk and found a new time save that skipped the whole car section and pizza section. You gotta love accidentally discovering something that helps you. Anyway, after that, I tried jumping to the shoe, but the character didn't grab onto it for some reason, so I fell to the bottom of the section. If that wasn't bad enough, I climbed back up and finally made it to the hoverboard, and while I was flying to the airplane, the dragon knocked me off and sent me to the bottom again. And here's the kicker, as I was climbing up yet again, the dragon swooped me off of the drumstick and sent me to the bottom one last time. This dragon is a paid actor. I can still PB. Come on, dude. This is so stupid. Stupid ass dragon. However, because my run prior to the dragon section was so good, I still had some time to PB. So I climbed up to the end one last time and finally made it. I had a clean space section and got a 44.39, yet another 5-minute improvement. Despite all of the shenanigans that occurred, I was improving at this game at a very consistent rate. I was on fire. I was absolutely unstoppable. I had time for one more run that night, and this run was extremely good. My first half was practically flawless. Everything was going my way, and I was actually on sub 30 pace going into the dragon section. Sadly, I failed the dragon skip, and then the worst thing possible happened to me.
Why didn't he grab? What the? Oh, well, that's GG. There was potential. And I'm gonna explore more of that potential tomorrow.
At this point, I decided to call it a night. I was extremely happy and proud of my progress, and made it a goal to defeat Ludwig's time the very next day. After getting so close to beating Ludwig, I was hoping that this would be the final day of runs. It took me a little while to finish a run, but my first finished run was 20 seconds slower than PB. That was a decent warm-up, but I can do a lot better than that. A couple hours later, I finally had a run that was on pace to beat Ludwig. I had a great pipe section and a clean jump at the train station bed. I fell down a bit at the oil rig and lost half a minute, but still continued with confidence. I had really clean movement into the subway where I did a cool dodge roll over this rail to skip the ledge grab. I got the windmill jump on the first try and made it to the bus station. I nailed the bed bounce to the highway and also the jump to the trampoline, and then bounced from the trampoline onto this red road. I had a super clean bounce from this bed to the elevator, where I did a mid-air dodge roll to fall to the ground faster. I was on a roll. After another great bed bounce, I made it to the halfway point at 11 minutes, a new halfway point PB. I also did some more optimal movement here that I found on my own, by jumping from the bones to the ball and back onto the bones in one swift motion, saving some more time over Ludwig, since he walks around to the left side here. I also do a more optimal cross jump here where I jump backwards without looking and grab the roof, and then get a clean bed jump on the way to Jesus. After nearly failing a ledge grab at the Hogwarts section, I swiftly proceeded to the chessboard, and it was time to do the bed bounce to the sunflower, which I successfully made on the first try. One cannon jump and champagne bounce later, I finally made it to the dragon section, and failed the skip because of a dropped jump input. I immediately started climbing up to the beanstalk section normally, and this time when I needed it most, John grabbed the shoe successfully, and I made it to the space section. Now let's see if I can make it to the end.
Let's go, dude. Let's go!
When you yay! Away, you don't hear
let's go!
Say, please obey me!
don't go. Simple and clean is the way that you're making me feel tonight. It's hard to let it go.
On my fifth day of playing this game, I finally achieved my goal of beating Ludwig's PB in Only Up. I was very happy with this, and with all of these goals checked off, I just had one more remaining. I decided that I would try to beat the game in under 30 minutes, but to do this, I had to learn some more updated strats. The first new jump was this bed jump from the train tracks, which takes you all the way to the train here. This bed was actually not present in the version that Ludwig was playing on, so I didn't use this bed during runs even though I knew it was there. This jump is pretty easy and probably saves 30 seconds to a minute. There is also a new bus station bed bounce that I learned, where you sprint to the bed from the roof, and before touching the bed, you roll in the air, and this lets you get enough momentum to get to the next bed much faster. I also learned a small optimization here where you jump from bed to bed, which was pretty easy. The hardest trick I learned was at the trampoline. Instead of bouncing on the trampoline and going to the red path, you can jump on the trampoline, get boosted by this tree with some extremely precise positioning, and make it to the top of the building where the next bed jump is. If you fail the jump to the top of the building, you can still make it to the floor underneath and just run to the elevator normally. Regardless of what happens, this new strat saves a bit of time, but the hard part was getting that boost from the tree. I then tried to learn another skip where you can jump from the chessboard bed straight to the bed by the pirate ship, but I was really struggling to learn the setup for this and decided it wasn't worth spending hours to learn, since I had no interest in grinding for the world record. Lastly, I learned a new champagne bottle skip. The way this works is you set the game to 30 FPS, and once you get on top of the bottle, you go into slow motion and crouch. Once the bottle shoots you up, you can release the slow motion button but stay still, and the game will shoot you up a second time, after which you can move forward and make it to the Rainbow Bridge area. The double bottle bounce saves almost 50 seconds compared to what I was doing before, and of course, I still had time to save by landing on the dragon, which I've only been able to do successfully in a run a singular time, so my chances were pretty slim here. Even so, I knew that if I was able to just nail all of the other tricks that I learned, I could definitely get a sub 30 run. Day 6 was very rough for me at first. I struggled for a couple hours to get a run finished. I kept failing the bus station bed bounce for some reason, and on one of my good attempts, I was struggling to get the correct angle on the double champagne bottle bounce, and I lost my PB. I opened the trainer mod again and practiced these two things for a bit, and figured out exactly what I was doing wrong. On the very next attempt, I finally finished a run. I got a good train track bed bounce, nailed the windmill jump and the bus station bed bounce. I got a perfect trampoline jump and made it to the top level right next to the bed. After all of that, I made it to the halfway point at the 9-minute mark. I was already 2 minutes ahead of PB. I just had to keep playing well. I had great movement after this and did the Hogwarts section much faster than before by performing some more risky jumps to get across the benches. When it was time to do the cannon jump, I unfortunately failed 2 times, losing over a minute. However, I continued to the champagne bottle and got the double bounce on my first try. The last hard skip was coming up, Dragon Skip. Like I said before, I had only pulled off the skip successfully once during a run, and that was on my very first speedrun, so the chance of me getting this was extremely slim.
Hold on, this looks really good actually. Dude. Oh my god. I freaking did it.
Just when I needed it most, I finally performed the dragon skip successfully. I jumped from the dragon onto the flags and climbed up to the space section. During the space section, I choked a bit and fell to the bottom, losing another minute, but I was still on pace for sub 30. I needed to calm down, so I did just that and made the rest of the bounces all the way to the end. My final time was 28 minutes and 20 seconds, a 3-minute improvement over my last PB. I was absolutely ecstatic. To think that I would have been able to beat the game in 26 minutes is crazy. I hope this video shows that anyone can become a speedrunner and motivate some of you watching into trying it out. And as always, huge thanks to my channel members for supporting my YouTube endeavors. Have a wonderful day.